before Twin Peaks. There was Hooterville. Now, return with all your favorites for the drama.
Oh, yeah.
The action.
Next time, I think I can flip you higher.
The insanity.
And you are invited.
Return to America's original strange town. Return to Green Acres. Friday night.
Oh, you're going to lose her to her father. Straight up. Where is your dad?
Sunday, Meg Tilly. In the best interest of the child.
Mama from the Train will continue.
First, the good news. You look good for your age.
Thank you. Yeah, Mom, you really look good.
Really?
Now, the bad.
Yesterday, 45. Today, 46.
Can Claire have her cake and eat it too? The Cosby Show.
Tomorrow at 5 on Channel 10. This is CBS.
The hardest thing is looking at my children.
Chris has leukemia.
For 6 days, what an attack.
Buddy gave Chris the gift of life.
Chris looks great today, and he's feeling great, and you know, we know it's going to work.
He gave his bone marrow.
I'm not a hero. He's my brother.
Learn how you could help save a life. Watch Sherry Banks' special report, You're the Cure, tonight on Channel 10 News. And put 10 people to work for you.
McDonald's casting. Get a cluck for a buck.
Action!
A cluck! A cluck! My kingdom!
Next!
For the cluck? What are you doing?
Get her out of here. Who let a mime in here? Listen, here's your motivation. Get a delicious McChicken sandwich for only a buck at McDonald's with the purchase of large fries and a large Coke. Next!
Cluck for a buck?
Yes! A cluck for a buck! Bigger! Bigger!
Cluck for a buck!
A cluck for a buck!
And a large fry and a large Coke!
Yes! Yes!
The Senior Golf Tour comes to the Delaware Valley, Sunday at noon on Channel 10. If you're on the brink of buying a new family car, bring home a Sierra and bring home up to $2,600 cash back. Hurry, this limited time offer ends June 4th. See your local Olds Connection dealer now and bring home the cash.
Abortion's the issue and the voters decide. Expanded election coverage at 11.
Throw Mama from the Train will continue.
Dan Rather interviews Gorbachev's right-hand man as pre-summit talks begin tomorrow. Setting the Summit, a CBS News special report, tonight at 11:30, 10:30 Central and Mountain.
In the season finale of Knots Landing, there's a deadly attraction.
I love you.
Who fell? The stalker is revealed.
Diane has been sending those letters. Don't you dare try and trap me.
And there's a wedding surprise.
We cannot find the groom.
What?
The finale you've been waiting for.
You need a lift?
Knots Landing, Thursday.
Garfield's comic imagination runs wild in search of the mysterious Banana of Bombay.
That was kind of fun.
It's all new Garfield's Feline Fantasies, Friday at 8:30.
This is CBS.
This is a Channel 10 Campaign 90 special report, the Pennsylvania primary. Good evening, everyone. I'm Larry Kane for Channel 10 News Campaign 90, and we've got quite a surprise tonight. First of all, not a surprise. Governor Casey, a big winner tonight in the Democratic nomination for governor. Governor Casey with 78%. Philip Berg, his challenger from Montgomery County, with about 22%. Casey with a 4-1 margin over Philip Berg. But here is the surprise tonight. A horse race is shaping up for the Republican nomination for governor of Pennsylvania. Barbara Hafer, Pennsylvania Auditor General, has 51% of the vote. And Marguerite Peg Luksic, the founder of a daycare center in Johnstown, Pennsylvania, has 49% of the vote. Of course, Hafer is the pro-choice candidate in this election. Luksic is the pro-life candidate. This is a very close contest with 63% of the vote in. Only 2 percentage points separates the two. Hafer with 51, Luksic with 49. We'll be watching this throughout the evening. A race that's being closely watched throughout Philadelphia tonight. In the Pennsylvania Senate, the nomination for the Democratic nomination for District 4 covering Germantown, Mount Airy, Chestnut Hill, Roxborough, and portions of Northeast Philadelphia, Allison Schwartz, backed by Congressman Bill Gray, a clear winner tonight. Consumer and government activist Jeff Blum in second place with 6,000 votes, and Robert Blasi, the well-known legendary leader of the 21st Ward in Roxborough, trailing now in third position. Blasi supported by the Democratic establishment and the ward leaders in that area with 4,200 votes. The one that the nation is watching tonight in Delaware County, the 166th legislative district, it appears tonight that Stephen Friend has survived the onslaught against him. The architect of the strictest anti-abortion legislation in America being congratulated by his friends and family tonight at his headquarters at Kavanaugh's in Drexel Hill. The clear winner tonight, Stephen Friend, very happy about this situation, and we'll be hearing from him at 11 o'clock. But a much different story at his opponent's headquarters tonight. Ellen Fisher conceded that she lost several minutes ago. She lost by 700 votes, and she had this to say to her followers at Critics' Choice, the restaurant in Havertown, Pennsylvania. And here's what Ellen Fisher had to say just as Stephen Friend was congratulating his family.
The one thing that is for sure, Pennsylvania will never be the same after that. Tonight we came within 700 votes.
Yeah.
700 votes of making Stephen Friend unemployed.
Yeah.
Ellen Fisher happy even though she lost tonight. Of course, Friend faces Democrat Alan Polsky, who was also a pro-choice candidate in November. Just briefly tonight, another key races, Frank Lynch apparently wins renomination in the 2nd senatorial district in Philadelphia, and in the hotly contested 192nd district in West Philadelphia, Louise Williams Bishop appears to be the winner tonight. We'll have the complete results in an expanded edition of the Channel 10 News Update when we see you at 11 o'clock. Right now, I'm Larry Kane for Channel 10 News, Campaign 90.